Hello and welcome to the Vector Garden YouTube channel. My name is Monika and in this video I'm going to talk about strokes that don't do as told. So I have this drawing and I'm going to select it all and I want to apply a different stroke to it. Let's apply a red stroke, like so. And you see this is somewhat reddish, but not quite. So let's zoom into this and you see there's a black stroke on top. So where does that even come from? I mean, when I'm selecting this, the stroke is obviously red. There's also no warning sign or anything. So where is that stroke located? And in order to check that, we're going to the Appearance panel, Window, Appearance. Or like this one. This icon is the Appearance panel, and let's take a look at it. So that looks just normal. We have the red stroke and no fill and everything's okay. But there is this entry on top of it, layer. And this shows us there's a stroke and fill, like this symbol, applied to the layer. So let's click it and there we see it. The layer has its own stroke, this one, and it's on top of the contents. So it's on top of the red one. Let's get rid of it. So what we can do is just click on here, clear appearance, and it's gone, like so. So there we have the red stroke. Now the next question is, why is that so? So why did this black stroke even exist? And for that, we have to take a look at selections. So of course, the black stroke might have been in the file deliberately because someone set it up so carefully. But often it also happens just by accident. And this comes because people don't select stuff in the appropriate way. So when I'm selecting something in here, then in the layers panel, which is this one, we can see the selection. It's like this. You see with this colored square that that path is selected. And also there is this circle in here, which is highlighted as well. And this circle is not a selection. So sometimes people use it as such. Now, when I'm clicking on here, you see this element gets selected and I can perhaps rotate it. But the selection actually is the colored square. So I click here and I get the same result. So this is the selection. Now, when a path is selected, then this all doesn't matter. The circle is the target symbol, and the target symbol is related to appearances. You see with this icon, it also has the circle. So the appearance symbol just shows me that I can now apply an appearance to that highlighted stroke, which I can do here. I can set that to yellow and then it's applied to this. Now the error I was talking about happens when you want to select all on one layer. Then what you have to do is click there in the selection column and then everything gets selected. And note that all the target symbols of the single paths are highlighted. But often what people do is not click there, but they click the target symbol. And then also you have all these objects selected, so you can rotate them or scale them or whatever, but they are not targeted. So when you now apply some appearance, then it gets applied not to the paths, but to the layer. So when you now choose a graphic style, for instance, like this one, then it gets applied to the layer, as we can see here. The target symbol is now gray, which means there's something applied to the layer. And that something we can see in the appearance panel, and there is the stroke again. So now you see how you can get rid of that weird behavior and also how it got into the file in the first place. If you liked the video, please give me a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. See you next time.